Welcome back to this war of mine. It is day 41. Let's see what needs to be done. Katya just came back. She's very tired. She needs to sleep. Pavel, you need to sleep. Amelia, I know you're drinking coffee or whatever, but you need to sleep too. Bruno, you're good. Looks like we have some more meat in the trap. Let's get things going. We need to finish the medicine up here. Vegetables won't be done until tomorrow. We should probably get some more water going. Okay. Seed the trap. Right, we don't have any fertilizer, right? No. So I'll just use one raw food to get two raw food eventually. Let's finish up the medicine. Actually, hold on. Never mind, I guess. Yeah, just keep going up. Okay, that's finished. Is that all the medicine? No, I think I can... Yeah, I can make one more. Or... Wait, what? I'm so confused, in a good way. Why did I think I needed four herbs to... I must have had two selected. Oh my god, I thought it required two med ingredients and four herbs to make one medicine. I must have had this set on two when I figured that out. Mistakenly figured that out. Holy crap, okay, so I can actually make four medicine. I thought I was only going to be able to make two. That is incredibly good. That medicine is worth a mind-boggling amount. Holy crap. Yeah, make it all. Damn. Also, I need to make it warmer in here. It's a little bit chilly. Wow, that is great. So that's going to leave me with six medicine. And at the moment, those seem to be literally the most valuable item in the entire game at this moment. I mean, hell, the herbal meds themselves were worth, like, 20-plus components. Damn. Okay, I need to talk about something, by the way. So remember at the end of the last episode, which was the start of this day? Remember how we got raided? And everything was fine, but we used up all of our 8 ammunition to fend off the raiders? Well, I want to note that my ammunition is back now. So, I've never talked about this before, but I should explain what's going on. So, every time you quit the game, like if I pressed leave right now, and load my game, the save game will be at the beginning of this day. So the save game is always at the beginning of each day. So that means what you saw at the end of the last episode when I got raided and used up the 8 rounds of ammunition, that means when I loaded my save game for this episode, it actually loaded the game from right before that happened. Like, it loaded the game right when the person was just coming home, and then it displays that screen where it shows you what you got and whether you got raided and stuff like that. And here's the awkward thing. What happened during the night, like whether you got raided and, you know, how much ammunition you used to fend off the raiders and stuff like that, that's randomized. Which is really weird because it's totally exploitable. So if you got like a really bad roll during the night, you could just keep ending the day and loading your save game until you get a good roll. And the reason this is awkward is because, yeah, at the end of... Or at the beginning of this day, at the end of the last episode, what happened is I got raided and I used up all of my ammunition. But when I loaded up this time, I just didn't get raided. So I have my ammunition back. Now this has happened before. And what I've done in the past is I just keep reloading my game until I get the exact same roll that I got before. So if I got raided and used up 2 ammunition, I just keep reloading until the same thing happens. But in this case, I can't make that happen. Like, I've loaded my game 4 or 5 times, and I've never even been able to get raided, let alone use up 8 ammunition. Every single time either nothing bad has happened, or in one case, Bruno was feeling a bit sick, but we never got raided. So I just can't make it happen, and I'm not gonna load my save game like 50 million times to force it, so that's why I just left it. So, kind of awkward, but there you go. I'm certainly not going to complain about having more ammunition. Okay, do I need water? No, I've got 18 water. I actually don't. Oh, I was gonna look into upgrading the metal workstation. Let's go check that out. Now I need wood. And electric parts. And making the mixer takes 4 electric parts on its own, so let's see, I need... Let's write this down. I need 6 wood. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 electric parts. And that's it. That's all I technically need, but I can't leave myself with only 2 components. I need more than that. Just for making filters. So, strictly speaking, I need 6 wood and 7 electric parts, but in reality, I need more if I'm to upgrade that. Okay, so, let's make some food. We have any vegetables left? Oh, we don't have any vegetables left. Right, those are gonna be done tomorrow. And I've only got 4 raw food, so I don't want to just cook that on its own. Because at this point, I don't really have a surplus of raw food. So I think I'm just gonna eat the canned food. Is anybody very hungry? Hungry. Nobody's very hungry. Alright. Oh, I forgot about the fireplace. Let's see if 1 log is enough. It might be. And do I have any filters already made? I don't. Should I just get more going? Yeah, why not? I'll need it in the future. Should I eat the canned food? I don't know. I probably should just eat it. I'm just gonna eat it. Okay, traps are all good. Water's going. Vegetables will be done tomorrow. Herbal meds are done. We need to check the radio. Got 6 medicines, so I should probably go trade tonight. Temperature's good. Yeah, we're doing good. Okay, nothing new. So where am I going tonight? I have plenty of meds, I should probably go trade. I could also go get wood. I don't need wood. I mean, I could use wood for this upgrade, but I need more than just wood. For this upgrade, I also need components, electric parts, and wood. So, yeah, I think I should go trade. So there's no tools I need to make, I'm good. People have eaten, nobody's sick, nobody's tired. Yeah, we're good. Okay, where should we go trade? Well, first, who's gonna do what? We're gonna go trade, so I guess definitely Katya should be the one scavenging. Let's have 2 people guard. Bruno's probably gonna do some cooking, so I'm gonna have him sleep, because I want him nice and fresh in the morning. Wake everybody up with his aromatic cooking. Herbs and spices that we don't have. Because I'll have both of them guard. Okay. Hotel or semi-detached house? Does it matter? Probably not. I think they have pretty similar stuff. But the last place I went to was the semi-detached house. So I guess the hotel is the one most likely to have replenished their stores. So let's go there. How many medicine should I bring? I should probably bring 2. That's a lot of medicine, though. They give me so much for 1 medicine. Am I gonna have enough to fill out my inventory with 1 medicine? I don't know. I'm gonna take two. Once again, let's be a little bit careful just in case raiders or something have come in here and taken residence. Probably the same people. Yep. Alright, so yeah, that is worth a crap ton. You don't have any food at all. And a disturbing lack of any rounds or components. I mean, you do have components, but not as many as I'd like. Okay, so I definitely want all of these. Could use a little bit of wood. What about electric parts? You don't have any electric parts. Bah. You're useless. I don't need any cigarettes or coffee. Got plenty of that. Don't need bandages. Don't need lockpicks. I guess just wood and filters? Again, filters are basically the equivalent of buying components. Yeah, look at this. I only need one medicine, and it's very generous for this stuff. Okay, so what else can I get? Okay, that's putting it closer to even. Guess let's get a little bit of wood. Okay, that won't do. I actually need more wood than components in this situation. Let me see. How much wood can I get? What if I don't get the filter? It might be better. But it does give me the 6 wood that I need, although I'm gonna have to, you know, turn some of it into fuel to make food anyway, so in reality I need more than 6 wood. And I don't have the electric part, so it doesn't really matter. No, you know what the fact is? I can always get wood. Wood is easy to get. For free. I don't have to trade for it. So let's trade for the stuff that I actually need. And what I need are components. Because that's the stuff I'm going to run out of. That's the stuff that barely exists in the world anymore. The wood, there's basically unlimited of. Especially if I take my choppy choppy axe with me. Okay, what else can I get? Herbies? Can I get some herbies? No. I guess water is, once again, a very roundabout way of getting components. I can get one water. One drop. One precious drop. This is the equivalent of wood. I can get one of those. Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, I thought making the medicine was... Or making the workshop to make the medicine was a terrible idea. Just because it took so much stuff. And in the short term, it indeed sucked. But in the long term, this is really worth it. I mean, look at how much stuff I can get for one medicine. I just spent one medicine. And I just got all of this stuff. That is so incredibly worth it. Probably gonna get through 3 nights in this episode instead of the usual 2, just because everything's gonna go by really fast. Mostly just go trade and then come back home. Let me guess, we were raided. Surprise! And... Okay, Pavel's starting to feel unwell, and this time we actually did use up all of our ammunition. Wonderful! So yes, I really, really, really do want to make that workshop, because I have no ammo now. Okay, so we have plenty of water, I don't need to make more. Who needs to sleep? Katya, you need to sleep. Pavel, you're slightly sick, you definitely need to sleep. Bruno, you slept, you're good, you're the only one that's good. Poor Amelia keeps trying to drink coffee, but she has to go to sleep. Even though she just drank coffee, so she's not going to be able to sleep, but whatever. Vegetables are going to be done. Good. We need another log in the fire. Let's just put two in here. Oh, I don't have any more fuel. Yeah, we should have 18, 20, like 26 water. Yep, 26. Well, based on past experiences, I think Pavel is probably gonna have to sleep for 50 years to get rid of his slight sickness. Stupid compromised immune system, based on our shitty diet of rats and vegetables. Okay, check the radio. Same thing as before. And nothing in the traps. Did I buy any filters? I don't think I ended up buying any filters. Did I? Maybe I did. Oh no, I did. Okay. 21 degrees centigrade. That's actually almost a little bit hot. It's probably in like the 80s. Yeah, I really, 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 really want to get this workshop working. So, I have a pretty comfortable amount of components now. So I just need electric parts and wood. I can get the wood by going scavenging. There's no way I can get enough electric parts, though, because I need 7. I might be able to find a couple, but I can't find 7. No way. So I need to trade for that. Gonna stay here and watch vegetables grow. Bum 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 bum. We need food. We're about to have food. Watch the miracle of life happen. Life always finds a way. What are you doing, Katya? Oh, she's going the hard way for a drink of coffee, isn't she? What do you bet? I think she is. You going for coffee? Mm-hmm. Whip out that cup. Come on, you know you want it. Still got 5 coffee left. Wait, didn't I have cigarettes? Didn't I have like 4 or 5 cigarettes? Where did they all go? Bruno, I think you got a problem, man. Oh yeah, look at this. Cups of coffee consumed per day, too. We like cigarettes. I just imagine Bruno, like, I have a shopping list that I go out with every time I go scavenging. Like, stuff we need. And Bruno just, like, scribbles in the side margin, like, give me some fucking cigarettes, I'm going crazy! God damn it! Coffee. You know you want coffee. Coffee, coffee, coffee. Vegetables done? No. I wish I could make her drink coffee. I want her to drink coffee. You disappoint me. Looks like Amelia's reading. Pavel's not tired anymore, but he's slightly sick. I wish I could speed up time, because there's nothing to do now but wait. I don't want to end the day. But I just need to wait. Come on, it's so close. Huh? Oh wait, he's smoking right now. Where did you- wait, where'd you get that cigarette? Bruno, what the hell? We don't even have any cigarettes. Did you pull that cigarette out of your ass? We better drop it, because we got some vegetables. In 3, 2, 1. I lied. 3, 2, 1. There we go. Alright, he needs to start cooking while Amelia goes and gets some more vegetables going. Let's get everybody to gather around. Need to eat. Okay, let's see if I can make everybody eat before the time runs out. Come on. Don't cough on the food, Pavel. Don't want everybody else getting sick. Wouldn't that be funny if you had somebody who was sick prepare the food? It, like, had a chance to make other people sick because he infected the food? Okay, I think we're good. Go get 2 seconds of sleep before the day ends. Alright, yeah, nobody's hungry. We're good. Temperature's good. No food in the traps. Water's good. Vegetables going. Oh! There we go. Okay, I think, yeah, this is gonna sum up everything I did. Our neighbor's children asked for medication for her. We shared the little we had with them. Yeah, I remember that early on. Day 5. Day 9, hungry children. The children we had helped earlier came to ask us for some food, but we couldn't help them. Yeah, we just literally didn't even have the food. The rebel investigation on day 18. The rebels asked if our neighbor had stolen supplies from a humanitarian aid container. We lied to them and denied it. Yes. The father and child with the sniper, day 30. Helped the man who was wounded by a sniper while coming home to a sick child. Mm-hmm. Neighbors in need. Our friendly neighbors came to ask for help and reinforcing their shelter. Sadly, we didn't help them.
I wanted to. I'm sorry.
Day 38. Plea for help. Our neighbor felt unsafe and asked us to help her board up her windows. We did that. Mm-hmm. Day 42, ceasefire. The long-awaited ceasefire finally came into force, eventually putting an end to the fighting in Pagoran. Those who managed to survive the war in something-something would never forget it. I still can't read that name. Okay, so let's see what happened to our survivors. After the war, Amelia became a public prosecutor in Pagoran. She used her law expertise in trials of war criminals who were brought to justice. She has never found out who the murderers of her family were, but deep inside, she hopes they got what they deserved. After the ceasefire, Bruno set off looking for his friend. Her neighborhood saw heavy fighting, and the majority of housing had been reduced to ruins. But she found shelter in the basement, which somehow held. Despite the hardships, she managed to survive and was happy to see Bruno alive as well. They remain friends to this day. Pavel survived the war. After months of searching, despite numerous difficulties, he managed to find his wife and son, who had sought refuge in France. He went there to live with them. They never came back to Pagoran. Katya used her contacts to find her parents in a refugee camp abroad. She brought them back to the city and helped rebuild their house. Soon after that, she published her war diary, which became a bestseller and drew widespread attention to the fate of civilians during war. Epilogue. Oh, is that to, like, just replay the thing I just saw? Just want to make sure. Yep, it is. Okay. Okay, so, yeah, that was unexpected. I mean, the radio kept saying the war is going to end any day now, but I was just like, yeah, whatever. It sounds nice, but, you know, I still need to keep on surviving in the meantime. Just another day. I was making short and long-term plans, trying to think of where to go to trade and get the parts I need to make more ammunition to defend myself, and then it just ended. Just like that. So, it was sudden, it was a surprise, but a very, very good surprise. So, I'm not sure if I'm going to make a review-type video about my experiences with the game or not, I'm not sure. But, basically in short, which you probably already know, I really like this game. It's really, really good. In pretty much every conceivable way. It's just a damn good game. So, it's been a long journey, it's been 40 plus days over what about, was this episode? This was episode 20. Yeah, 40 plus days, 20 episodes. And I managed to keep everybody alive on my very first try through the game. I'm pretty proud of that. Yeah. Definitely made some mistakes. Some mismanagement of my supplies and... yeah, quite a few accidents. Accidentally ending the day, mismanagement of supplies, building things that I, well, early on thought I shouldn't have built, but then later on it ended up working out. I mean, look at the vegetable garden. That sounded like a good idea, and then when I first built it, I thought, oh my god, this is stupid, like, this cost me so much stuff and it's not going to do anything for so long. But it ended up becoming extremely important. And the medicine thing, which also seemed like a bad idea at the beginning, ended up being a good idea, although I wish I did it like a week earlier, because I didn't have time to trade all the medicine that I made from it. So even the stuff that seemed like a really bad idea and a massive waste of supplies actually ended up working out for the most part. Quite a few things I would definitely do differently, like board up my windows a lot quicker. Not sure what else, but there's just a lot of little ways I'd be more efficient with my supplies. But yeah, that worked out really well. Kept everybody alive. I managed to keep everybody's... like, I managed to keep my morals intact. I never stole from anybody who wasn't some sort of a rebel asshole. You know, I never stole from my neighbors, my civilians, my civilian friends. Never killed anybody. I helped where I could. Didn't help where I couldn't. And in one case, accidentally gave my neighbors the cold shoulder. Didn't mean to. But I got everybody out alive and without losing their humanity in the process. I'm pretty proud of that. So yeah, thank you everybody who gave me tips and told me what the hell was going on with certain things, like telling me what the upgraded stove did, because I had no idea. Apparently it uses less, I think it's less water and also less fuel to cook food. Because after I upgraded that, it just seemed like nothing changed. But yeah, thanks to everybody that gave me little tips along the way. Thanks for the tip about not going back to the hospital ever, even with a different character. Because apparently they would shoot me, even if I went back with a different character that never stole from them, or, you know, started to steal from them. That's good to know. Yeah, just lots of little tips and stuff like that, so thanks. Thank you to everybody, and I hope you enjoyed watching me play through this war of mine.